Subscribe to Simplified Biology channel and press the bell icon to get notified when a new video is uploaded. Hello friends, welcome to Simplified Biology. Today's topic is inflorescence of the chapter Morphology of Flowering Plants. Inflorescence. Now, inflorescence is arrangement of flowers on the inflorescence axis or the stem axis. The arrangement of flowers on the stem axis is known as inflorescence. Now, the stem axis on which the flowers develop is referred as peduncle. Peduncle is the inflorescence axis on which the flowers develop. Now, this also is a peduncle. Stalk of the flowers is known as pedicel. Now, this is the pedicel, and bract is a leaf-like structure which may be green in color or may be of different colors. Bract is a leaf-like structure in the axil of which a flower develops. Now, in this picture, we can see this is a bract. This is a bract on the axil of which the flower is developing. This too is a bract. The flower develops on its axil. Same here. Inflorescence can be broadly divided into two types, the racemose and the cymose. In case of racemose inflorescence, the main axis of the stem never terminates with the flower. Due to which the main axis is of indefinite growth, or you can say it is interdeterminate or indefinite. Such type of a growth is also known as monopodial growth, means there is a single main axis and the flowers develop in acropetal succession. Which means the lower flowers are the older ones and the upper flowers are the younger ones. So in case of racemose inflorescence, the main axis, that this is the main axis, it will never terminate with the flower, due to which the main axis will grow continuously. Such type of growth is known as intermediate, interdeterminate or indefinite growth, due to which a single main axis is present. Hence, it is also referred as monopodial growth. And the flowers develop in acropetal succession, which means the lower ones are the older ones while the upper ones are the younger ones. While in case of cymose inflorescence, the main axis always terminates by a flower. Which means the main axis has a limited growth, or we can say the main axis is determinate or having definite growth. And such type of growth is known as sympodial growth. Means when from the main axis develop a flower, it restricts there and then lateral branch develops, which then starts growing, that terminates by a flower. So in case of cymose inflorescence, it is sympodial growth. And the flowers develop in bicipital succession. Bicipital succession means the upper ones are the older ones, the upper flowers are the older flowers, and the lower flowers are the younger flowers. So in case of cymose inflorescence, the main axis always terminates by a flower, means the main axis growth is restricted. Such type of growth is known as determinate or definite growth. And in this case, there is not a single main stem, hence it is referred as sympodial growth. And the flowers develop in bicipital succession. That is, the upper flowers are the older flowers and the lower flowers are the younger flowers. Now, besides the racemose and cymose inflorescence, there are certain special types of inflorescence which we'll study later. Now, besides this, sometimes or in some plants, a single flower develops at a fixed position. There is no particular arrangement. Such type of flowers are known as solitary flowers, or such inflorescence is known as solitary inflorescence. Means a single flower develops at a particular region. When the flower is terminal in position, it is known as solitary terminal. And when the flower is axillary in position, means develop in the axil of a leaves, it is known as solitary axillary. Now in the next video, we'll study racemose and cymose in detail. So that's all for today. Please do like, subscribe and comment, and also visit our website by clicking on the link given below. Thank you for watching.